welcome back to our channel. So today we're going to be cooking Liboke mbisi, which is steamed sea bream. And normally they use banana leaves to cook it, but we're going to be using aluminum foil. And this is a Congolese dish. Other than the sea bream, the side dish that we're going to be using is plantains, which is called... Plantains. That's called makemba ya kotokisa. And that is boiled plantain. Okay, so the ingredients that we're gonna be using today are all pretty much here. So we're gonna be using 3 spring onions. I just got a batch of them. 5 garlic cloves, 5 Maggi cubes, 2 tomatoes, 2 scotch bonnets, 1 lemon, 1 onion, garlic granules, all-purpose seasoning, and our sea bream. And we've got 4 of them there. So first up, we're gonna start by cutting our gills. So the next step, so we've cut all the gills out, and the next thing that we're gonna do is wash the fish with warm water. So can you just turn the top on because I'm not wearing gloves? And we're just gonna get all this blood and anything else, the residue that's inside the fish. All the fish is cleaned inside out, and the next thing that we're gonna do is cut the fish in half. So I need a cutting board for you. Okay, and once we cut it in half, we're just gonna slice a little bit on the surface of the skin, just so that the spices and go into the actual fish meat and that it's well marinated. And now that I've cut all of them up, so they're all in here. Alright, so we've cut them all in half now and we've done our slices on the surface just like that. And now I'm gonna wash it with warm water and lemon. Slice my lemon.
And why are you using lemon?
We're using lemon so that we can get rid of the fishy kind of smell of it, and I guess so we can kill bacteria as well. So this is our fish cleaned now. I've just dumped the water with the lemons, and we're just gonna start adding our spices. Okay, so the first spice that we're gonna put is the 5 Maggi cubes that I showed you in the beginning, and I've just crushed them on the plate. The next one is I'm going to put 1 tablespoon of all-purpose seasoning. Okay, next I'm going to put a teaspoon of garlic granules. That's enough. I don't want to put too much because we are going to put the 5 cloves as well. And finally we're going to put our nutmeg, which I forgot to show in the beginning. Okay, so now I'm just gonna mix it. And make sure that I put it everywhere in all the crevices that we cut the fish. So all these scores are called. And inside the fish as well. And what did I wanna say? Oh yeah, we're just gonna let it marinate for an hour. But if you're marinating it for 24 hours and you're making it the next day, then that's even better because the spices will be embedded into the fish. So while the fish is marinating on this side, I'm just gonna make the sauce that we're gonna put into the fish. So I'm gonna put our 5 garlic cloves. I put half an onion, 2 scotch bonnet, and I've just cut up 3 spring onions. Okay, so we've just made our sauce in the mixer, and we're going to add it to our fish that has been marinating for 10-15 minutes. Smells so good. I'm just gonna add a little bit of water into the mixer because as I was trying to pour it, it's a little bit too thick. Oh, it's coming out now. Just as I said, I'm gonna add the water. Yeah. Okay, well, I'm gonna add water anyway, just so I can get all the residue out and get the most out of the sauce. So I'm just gonna mix this sauce around. So now that we've mixed it in the sauce, I'm just gonna let it marinate for a further 45 minutes to an hour. Yeah. And we'll get back to you with the next step. So our fish has been marinating for an hour now, or just a little bit over an hour. And we're going to add our tomatoes, which we didn't add in the sauce. We've cut off the aluminum foil over here, and we are going to double up. Actually, that's why we've got so many, just so that we make sure that the sauces don't come out of it. I've already placed a double layer of aluminum foil in a bowl, and I'm just using this bowl so that I can give it its round shape before I start placing the fish and the sauce. I'm gonna put two pieces of fish into the bowl. Place my fish with the sauce, and I'm just gonna close it up. So our fish is secured in the aluminum foil. We've added a little bit of water into our pot, just a little bit to avoid it going into the foil. And I've turned on the hob on medium because we don't want it to boil, we just want it to steam. And I'm gonna start placing these into the water. And we're gonna let them steam for around 20 minutes. On the oven at 200 degrees, so we're preheating it while the fish is steaming. It's almost done. And we've got our tray. I just put a little bit of water inside so that the fish can continue steaming inside the oven. And we will leave it for around 40 minutes in there. Yeah. We're gonna put this into the oven for 40 minutes. All right, so while we're waiting for our fish to cook in the oven, we've cut up the plantain in half. I've cut around 8 plantains, and I'm just gonna leave that to boil. I think it takes around 20 to 30 minutes to boil, but I'll just keep checking with a fork. I'm gonna add my water and then just place it in. Okay, so we've just taken out the fish from the oven, and this is what it looks like. Oh, and I've peeled the plantains as well. And there we go. It smells really, really good. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you tried this dish out, then let us know in the comments below. Let us know any other video recommendations that you'd like to see on our channel, and make sure you like and subscribe. Taste test.
Wow.
Good?
Jesus. Worth the wait.